angels and demons. Closes here at 2, and sometime after 10. Let's see how you hold out. Now, I got up at 6 o'clock this morning, 6 a.m., in Baltimore, in a hotel which was even the lift had a bad smell. And I got to the airport and waited for around 10 minutes. I met a neurologist at the airport who tapped me on the shoulder and said, "Hey, are you Marty?" And yes. I said, "Oh, yeah." And he talked about me for about 20 minutes. I said, "What do you do?" He said, "I'm a neurologist." He was the most interesting guy in the whole universe. It was really amazing. I just didn't want to talk about, you know, the church or crap, you know. I want to talk about neurology, you know. It took 3.5 hours to get to Denver, and then waited for 2 hours. And then another plane took 2 hours to get here that was 40 minutes late. And was straight to an in-store in the Tower Records. So it took me 10 hours of traveling to get to Austin, Texas. And I wonder if you can hold out. Do a song. is a song which needed to be written. It's always great when you can write a song about a subject that nobody's dealt with. That's a real achievement. And in fact, I'm going to be writing a song very soon about dwarves on acid. Subject people have strayed away from. Or dwarf tossing on acid. Anyway, this is a song about the radio stations, you know. I did this at the Instore, so if you could come and learn on it, so we were pretty cool about doing the same story and the same song. Every time you put a radio on, you either hear Supertramp or Whitney Houston. There's got to be something wrong with that. You know, I mean, I'd rather hear, you know, a bunch of blokes from the local, you know, titty bar singing. And used to be had the record, I sat there and read the lyrics throughout the whole record. I'll talk about that later. Okay, this is this song is from the first track on Hanging Out Now, and this is called Forget the Radio. We believe it's not going to make an inch of difference, but you still don't believe. Switch on your amplifier and put a record on. Lay back on your pillow and hear your favorite song. Feel the music breathe, sing the melody. Read the sleeve notes through what the musicians do. And when you found the groove, or if the lyrics suit, concentrate and listen really close. Forget the radio. Singing the DJ hum. You better on your own. Forget the radio. All my favorite records I never see again. lighting over there is interesting. Yeah, the bar, isn't it? There's a little sort of fairy-like thing. It seems flashing on and off. Or is it just me that sees it? I think they are flashing on. They've got some kind of weird time. They do, they're kind of very slow and subtle.
So if you were really drunk, you sort of might say, I think I'm better still. So Hanging Out in Heaven was made a long, long time ago. It started a long time ago. The guy that was working with the record was got in a band that played in the Titanic film. The band that was actually on the Titanic in the film. It's weird, but so he sort of didn't have time for me to finish my record. It took years to get it together, although it was pretty much done by the time.
was a song you could relate to being in Texas because it's all watery. And here it's all dusty. So, you know. Do you get water here apart from your taps? You have a lake? A lake. Are they going?
Saturday, love. tomorrow. Always the next day, what to find? Century for this room, kept promises, crimes and jealousies. Always the next day, what to find? Century. Silence remains on the bed till the hue of the sun whispers heat to the dead. And the glow won't wash out when you're already gone. So you lock all the doors where the silence just shone. A sip of green poison that chains my blood till the blue of your face turns as brown as the mud. The continental shift in your earthquake heart, it isn't the cure, but at least it's a start. And it's red, well, Saturday. Love tomorrow. Always the next day. What to find? Said you. What is it? Keep promises. Crimes and jealousies. Always the next day. What to find? Said you.
We're lucky to be alive and not speaking German.
fought for 5 years in that war. And, you know, sometimes he comes up to me and he says, I'm John Silver, you know. Me, flamey Lancaster. You must be in German now. Actually, when I was 18, I made the big mistake having a German girlfriend in West Berlin. Tatiana Schroeder was her name. She was absolutely gorgeous. And my dad used to call me up and he used to say, "How's that little kraut?" I used to say, "Oh, she's fine, Dad, thanks. I won't put her on." Anyway, she ended up having sex with another girl, and that was the end of the relationship. I was in love with her for 10 minutes.
But she had a birthmark there. She had an oval birthmark there.
She's probably married to somebody now, some industrialist. Probably making bombs. No, she was great, she was fantastic. I think I sort of digressed somewhere here. So if I remember, if I say anything insulting about America tonight, my girlfriend is American, alright? So it's not like a personal thing. It's just something that comes out in conversation.
Right.
I love America. Okay, so anyway, Jesus, back to the music. This is from the very deleted Art Attack record, which I actually just got all the rights back to, and I own that record, which is a very interesting concept. I actually own one of my own records. And sometime in the next year or something, it's going to come out again, it's going to be available. I hope to put the video of She's King on the CD like that. So, I also had this funny idea of putting the 6 tracks that, from In Reflection that didn't get on the account. Not that you need them because In Reflection is now available, but just for fun. So anyway, this is a track from Art Attack. This is called, this is the arpeggio from Hell, all budding guitar players. This is you whisper, you whisper.
Fears, the loads of my mind. the pointed beating pulse. We're stabbing and stabbing my thumping head. This famousness is false. You glow and glint, I blink, you wink, last polished silk. You whisper.
Maybe time, okay. The thing is that if you get past this during the evening, okay,
right?
If you get past it during the evening, well, if you get past it during the evening, that's P-A-S-S-E-D, not P-A-S-T. If you get past it during the evening, make sure you give me back, otherwise it's 15 songs in the set that I can't do. But just feel it. Start with Ben here. Just pass it around. Make sure you do like that with it first though. But make sure you give it back to me when I need it.
Oh, okay.
Otherwise, we know Bon Jovi songs tonight. Now, there's a thing I can do tonight. I can, Griff said to me, "Do you want to do two sets or one?" And the thing I thought was, if I did two, that would mean there would be a gap where I couldn't play a load of songs. So, you know, just see how it goes. So if you start to get restless, I'll stop and then let you have a break. But if you don't get restless, then I'll just keep on playing for hours, okay? Bruce Springsteen, huh? Okay. In Reflection used to be the rarest record in the world. Are you clapping? It's rareness. It's rareness. Yeah.
We're clapping because we all have it.
It's like I've got the Butcher Beatles album, and sometimes I pull it out and go, there it is, and I clap it. And I think I own it, so I have to clap it. You know? And you obviously have the same feeling about it in Reflection. Hey, I have to relate. I think I'm losing my tangent direction here. What was I talking about? Oh yeah, it's Rare Records. And this is the other Rare record which I've released, which is the Seeing Stars album. Now this is very rare because it's only been put out on a little Swedish label. And sometimes I bring copies over to America to sell, you know, people want to get hold of it. And every time I get to somewhere like Austin, I've sold out. You know, like in Reflection, I sold out. And this is a track from that record. This is the record I did. Some of you may be aware, I'm also, apart from being in the church, I also played with the band called All About Eve.
Oh, yeah.
Right. You were a really fantastic group, if you like that kind of thing. You know, if you like Prodigy, forget it. But this is a girl singer. He's got a really beautiful voice. I'm the guitar player and the bass player and drummer. And this is the record that we made after she left the band. Because we did two records and then she sort of, Julianne decided she wouldn't do it anymore. Andy Mark and I made this record. This is what Andy and I wrote together. Since that time has happened, we've all remained good friends and we've reformed and want to get back to England in May, doing a British tour. All About Eve is way back in the fixtures, you know. But this song is kind of blue-shaped. It's kind of like a little crescent on it. At the end of the crescent, like a moon, there's like a little chain. It's kind of a little silver chain. There's little pieces of jet in it. And the jet sparkles whenever it gets near anything that's aquamarine. And aquamarine is really interesting because it's like the colour of the
the ocean. And the ocean is huge. But we're in Texas. So it doesn't matter if the ocean's huge. Does it? Because you ain't going to see it. It doesn't matter if the ocean's huge if you even live by the ocean, because you can only see as far as you can see. Didn't think of that, did you?
No.
Golf, I'm saying. Let's talk about golf, yeah. Tiger Woods. Tiger Shark Woods. Tiger Shark Woods. It's a breed of fish that plays golf under the sea. It's a hybrid, half Asian. Huh? Engulf. Engulf? Hey, come on, we'll do this. Engulf. I know it was an Eeyore day today, so let's engulf. The Eeyore day. You've got a lot of explaining to do about that one. I'm weird, but I'm going on about, hey. Okay, anyway, seriously, this is a song about, Andy and I wrote this, my mate Andy, not Andy who's on my records, but Andy from All About You. This is a song about when you gotta stop it, but when you've stopped, you just can't live without it. Mm. Tragic. It's a thesis based on the theory that
hand to be activated. Just get X-Files, don't you? So anyway, so this thesis is based on the theory that the reason that cats are implanted in our houses is that what we imagine cats are these lovely, but they're aloof, which is a clue. You'd better watch out. You're lying in bed with it by the side of you. Because it'll rip your breasts off. There won't be any titty bars anymore. Thanks for a dollar. Glad you're so impressed.
Silence floats into the room. Whispers to me, out of tune. And I wonder if these deadly, awkward moments stay, stabbing the spikes in me. Will I start to bleed? Raise your eyes until they're mine. Lift yourself towards light. Your face looks like a waterfall to me. If I can see, what is it gonna mean? Will I start to bleed? Glad I didn't stay with you. There's so much more for me to do. 'Cause I am free, like mentioned in the Age of Reason. But something's missing. Will I stop to bleed?
Mr. Matthew has, of course, to start with Age of Reason, existential novel, which you have to read to get the point of your mind there, which is... there's a road in Austin, and on the bend of that river, a historic event happened. Did you hear that guitar players? Don't you hate when that happens? Let's do it again. Oh, don't do it. And that historical event involved a rare bat. A rowing boat, a trout, and a cricket team who were camping, fishing and camping in a rowing boat. They don't have cricket in America because you're so point obsessed. So winner obsessed that you can't have a game which you play for 5 days
and the result is a draw. You know? Which is why soccer isn't working here. Because I know that I was talking to an interesting taxi driver from El Salvador out there, and he was telling me that they changed that law where you have to have a penalty shootout at the end so that somebody wins. That's the law that's been changed. Another point that I'd like to make is that in England, soccer is thought of as a wimpy slacker sport, rather like musicians are thought of. And so in America, sports, as you like to call it, somehow the S on the end seems to completely change it, like just to be electronic and electronica. Put an A on the end and it suddenly goes corporate. It's really weird. Anyway, the thing is that here, people who play sports seem to be kind of a bit like this shape, and they sort of don't have any sort of aesthetic pursuit in their, they don't have an aesthetic bone in their body. Whereas in England, you know, like Robert Smith, for example, would be, and Ian McCulloch and Bernard Sumner would all be huge soccer fans, and they would go to games and they would go mad and they'd cheer, they'd get drunk and they'd have a great time. Whereas here you couldn't imagine Eddie Vedder at the Orioles game going, "Oh, holy lost." You know, could you? You just couldn't imagine it, because he would be the antithesis of what sports stands for, whereas in England it doesn't stand for that. Interesting. So I made a point the other day about how the problem with music these days is that it's full of aggressive people and careerists. And what it used to be full of was wimps and slackers. You know, and wimps and slackers used to be able to make it. And now, if you're a wimp and a slacker, then you're sort of like still, you know, working in the record shop trying to get a demo out, you know, which is admirable and, you know, a thing to be proud of, you know, because you're doing what you believe in. But, you know, I don't believe that to write a great song you have to do 200 push-ups every morning, or you have to sort of like have ironic hate songs like the Bloodhound Gang. I don't know, I told you I read their lyrics before, did I? Or was that the install? Anyway, yeah. I read the Bloodhound Gang's lyrics, and all the songs are about hating somebody, hurting somebody, or killing somebody, or being nasty to somebody, but they don't really mean it. And they wear silly suits with ears on them to prove that they don't really mean it. Because if the Gestapo had silly suits with ears on it, they wouldn't have been so evil, would they? They just would have been silly people who were trying to be ironic. Can you imagine an ironic Gestapo? I think we should better leave you with that thought to a song. Okay, let's do She's King. Let's stay on.
Unbelievable time. Wow. Single life.
Actually, which he didn't see, and the tour that was 10 years ago, so sorry about that. So 1990 was the last time we went through. And even then we didn't play this song, and probably not many times before that. This is a song from, anyway, the last couple of tours we didn't do any songs from Remote Country, which is a kind of a new 1984, I think. And this is a song which kind of the band's moved on, you know. Sometimes you just can't. It's like the Beatles doing Please Please Me in 1969. It just doesn't make sense, you know. Or The Who doing I Can't Explain in 1990. But this song works really well acoustic, and I talked to Steve about it. I said, Steve, I'm going to do it now. And he said, and we spent an hour discussing what other church songs I should do, because I had the opportunity to tour America and he didn't. So what I was thinking of doing is doing a solo tour and then doing a sort of a covers tour of the church, you know, where I sing all the songs Steve usually sings. But I'm sure you'd rather wait for Steve to do that. But anyway, this is a song that Steve wrote. It's called Into My Hands. Sometimes it's hard to play
just focus it on, or is it just, I mean,
bladed?
Or the focus?
Like,
no, we don't, it's auto.
Like, when you're driving a car, and it, you've just broken the speed limit by 80 miles an hour, and however hard you try, you just cannot drive slow. The car just won't do it. Whatever happens, the car will not go slow, it will only go fast. Well, guitars are the same. Sometimes they like to be in tune. Sometimes they like to be in various other keys. But my guitar tonight only wants to play in G. Really strange. This is a beautiful key, isn't it? Isn't it? G minor. It's the key G minor. It's beautiful. It's kind of like, it sounds like you're going to go, oh, lost my love, oh, no. What song is that? What is it?
Green Sleeves.
Green Sleeves, that's what it is. Yeah. Green Sleeves. Green Sleeves. See, that's what I was talking about that today in the in-store I did at Tower. It's like, you have a different folk tradition here. You have this thing about railroads. I was thinking of American folk as a railroad tradition, whereas for us it's like bowls of fruit and women with large breasts and lutes and kings having their wives beheaded. You know, it's like a little, your stuff's about, well, I went down the railroad, I turned around on the track, and I looked over there, and I looked back. But ours is all about, alas, sweet maid, I love thee so. You know, your breasts are bulbous and growing so. So, completely different, whole different thing, it's a different tradition. Anyway, the whole concept of being indoors, our clubs close at 11 o'clock, you know, the whole concept of being indoors is something which maybe we entertain more than you do, because you have a fantastic climate and you spend the whole time staying indoors to keep away from the climate. Sorry, I just realised what I was saying. Anyway, this is about loving the rain. Dripping down the window pane, the sky's opened up again, treating me to welcome rain. I'm glad it's here. It turns the trees to liquid green, encourages a glossy sheen upon the bark and on the leaves. It's loud and clear. Taking coats from secret cupboards, gloves and scarves, and large umbrellas, simple and peculiar to enjoy. Simple melody that hopefully won't ever go away. Splashing footsteps down the lane, puddles filling, then remain. Sparrows glad the bathtubs came, fluffed and clean. Grey electric, moody sky, clouds to lower. If I try to touch them, I can't reach that high. Still it seems so. When I spin and I turn to I dance, what have I done to earn this day? So simple and peculiar to enjoy. Simple melody that hopefully won't ever go away. I rush on home to get me dry, to sit me down right by the fire, to read a book and be inspired. My favorite room, Mozart climbed into my head, fell asleep, should go to bed. Music woven from the dead. I hear your home, come on. You join the open heart, cheat the night, run out into the dark. Simple and peculiar to enjoy. Simple melody that hopefully won't ever go away. Melody of the rain.
I couldn't move. I'm
face. You make my feet like lumps of lead. The nearer you come, the slower I get. You act like the ocean, but you only get wet. Peace, peace, don't open your mouth. You'll only begin what you already started. The only thing is the one you don't make. And no one opposes the things you can't take.
Too beautiful, a day to die, too.
Jellyfish, transparent purses that sting the strength of hoarded gold. The gifts they buy remain unsold. But what's the worth of the dead's desires when waterlogged are life's cold fires, with seaweed hair and barnacle bones, and a powerless court and a seashell throne? And back on land, your loved ones wait for news that saunters in too late, as salty tears mix with the sea as they wait for all eternity. And later on, that is discovered, a defiant ring that graced your lover, but to the sea now he is wed, in a ceremony of the dead, to purify the day to die, to be memorable, to be forgotten, a sea of tears to wave goodbye, a silent wreck to haunt the bottom.
Seems too weak. I'll regenerate with
there was a song which I wrote which was all the chameleons, the saints, my leather jobs. The list goes ever on modern English. And then America got its sort of personality back, its identity. And came out with R.E.M. started to get big, Pearl Jam, Stone Temple Pilots, Soundgarden, Nirvana, of course, Screaming Trees, you know, all that sort of stuff started to be really, really popular. And now the English band's sort of part of Oasis, who are terrible. I've got every record they ever made, you know, I always buy everybody's record, I try to buy everybody's record in the whole world, but I do know that record isn't really happening, that record isn't really happening, even though it's very huge, it's big, ain't good. And I think that it's interesting what's happened now, because who is big in America now who's kind of got an alternative slant? Is there anybody? See, I mean, listen, you know?
Well,
God, my voices are big. I tell you who's great. It's two bands who are great. Flaming Lips.
Yeah.
Excellent band. Mercury Rev.
Yeah.
Some fantastic songs, and one of the lines of it is, oh, the Spanish candles and the Persian palms. Beautiful. They've all got a bit rocky, didn't it? You know? I never met anybody in America who likes Pearl Jam. You know, but they were supposed to be standing for something, which was the alternative. They were the guys that fought the Ticketmaster thing, and you know, the T-shirt thing. They were the political thing. They were supposed to mean something, but nobody likes them, and yet they're huge. Because I don't know, it's like, we have this band in England called Ocean Colour Scene, who nobody likes, but are huge. It's really strange. I told you we're kind of the same kettle of fish. Spiritualized, really. Yeah, they're just a bunch of junkies, aren't they? That's a copy. That taking heroin with the right music. Okay. No, nothing against people taking heroin as long as they don't die in front of me. So anyway, this has nothing to do with anything I just talked about, but this is a song which was the closest I got to being American. And now I've got an American girlfriend. In 15 years, if we do move to Los Angeles, I'll come here and I'll say, hey, it's really nice to be here in Austin. No, this is a song about the Cadillac. Well, the wings of the Cadillac look pretty pointed to me. And I no longer drink cups of tea. Okay, this is called Questions. This is from Ryan. This is called Questions Without Answers.
All right.
Is it true?
So I say, doesn't seem to make a difference. Should I give in? That's not a point of reference. But the passive masses being eaten by TV, ignore cruelty, and Satan is not me. Well, we have this little thing that I do every night. I don't like to repeat myself too much, but playing the same songs would be nice, I suppose, as doing them. Having a set list, making a record and playing more than once is, by definition, but it's the time for hope or despair, where you have to decide. I've got two songs which have a capital on the fifth fret. One's about hope, the other's about despair. And it's up to you which order I do them in. So do you want hope?
Despair.
Despair.
You wouldn't believe how different it is in different places, how people react. It's fantastic. Tonight, total despair. What does that tell you about Texas? Fantastic. I love it. Do you think it's something to do with the fact that
there's no water?
There's no water.
Killed him or bought his idea, whatever it was, for $1,000,000,000,000. But the last thing they wanted was some event, something like that. But that story obviously didn't reach it. That's a huge thing that the car wouldn't get. Which